tutorial. Now, in this video, I'll explain you the basics of Arduino microcontroller as we will use it for our programs. So, Arduino is an open source hardware board which is used by electronic hobbyists, artists, designers, and even electronic newbies for building projects related to electronics. Since it is an open source hardware board, the design files of Arduino are made publicly available online by its developers. The Arduino IDE, that is Integrated Development Environment, uses a simplified version of C++, thus making it easier to learn programming. The Arduino board generally consists of a USB connector, a DC jack, ATmega microcontroller, crystal oscillator, voltage regulators, reset switch, etc. And it can interact with components like buttons, LEDs, speakers, GPS units, cameras, internet, and even your smartphones. The Arduino board that you're seeing right now is the Arduino Uno, and it is one of the easiest Arduinos to get started with. Now, for explaining the Arduino Uno, I'll first divide it in 6 different parts. You can see these parts in front of your screen. I will start explaining from this top left part over here. I basically call this part as the communication part. This part mainly consists of a USB connector, a reset switch, and an ATmega 16U2 chip. The Arduino board requires 5 volts of power for operation. And when we connect the Arduino to a laptop or to a computer using the USB, it gets that required 5 volts. Programs are uploaded from the laptop to the Arduino using this USB. Neighboring to the Arduino, there is an ATmega 16U2 chip. This chip is basically used for USB to serial conversion. On the top, as you can see, the Arduino consists of a reset button. We can use this button to reset the Arduino. Now, if you look at this part over here, which is on the lower left side, then this part is called as the external power supply part. This part consists of a DC jack connector and a voltage regulator. So guys, after uploading the program in the Arduino, if we want to give external power supply to it, then we can provide external power using this DC jack connector. We can supply external power between 7 volts to 12 volts using a battery or an adapter. The maximum supply that we can give is around 20 volts. The Arduino also consists of a voltage regulator which converts higher voltages to 5 volts. So, even if you supply an external voltage of more than 5 volts to the Arduino, the voltage regulator is the one that reduces the voltage to 5 volts, thus protecting your Arduino from higher voltage damages. Next, let's talk about the Arduino microcontroller board. The Arduino Uno consists of an ATmega 328 microcontroller. The ATmega 328 is a 28-pin microcontroller, out of which 20 pins are data pins. Out of these 20 data pins, 14 pins are digital data pins and 6 pins are analog data pins. We can use the data pins either as input or as output. Some technical specifications of this microcontroller are: it consists of a flash memory of 32 KB, SRAM of 2 KB, EEPROM of 1 KB. The Arduino board also consists of a 16 MHz crystal oscillator. And as I told you earlier, the Arduino board consists of 14 digital pins, which are labeled from 0 to 13. If we look at pin number 0 and 1, then over here RX and TX is written, which stands for transmitter and receiver. So, we can basically use pin number 0 and 1 for serial communication, that is for communication between a Bluetooth, GSM, or even your computer. Now, if you look over here, the Arduino consists of a transmit and receive LED. These LEDs will blink when we upload the program from the computer or whenever a data is transmitted to the Arduino. The LED above the transmit LED, which is labeled as L, is internally connected to pin number 13 of the Arduino. So, we can control this LED by writing a data on pin number 13. An Arduino consists of 6 analog pins, which are labeled from A0 to A5, and we can use these pins for connecting analog sensors or analog devices. The analog values that we can plot using the analog pins is in the range of 0 to 1023. Neighboring to the analog pins, we have the power pins. Now, using the power pins, we can supply power to the sensors and other electronic components that run at 3.3 volts and 5 volts. So, as you can see, there is one 3.3 volt pin and one 5 volt pin for supply. The Arduino consists of 3 ground pins, two pins at the bottom and one pin at the top. The Arduino consists of an on LED. This LED will basically turn on when Arduino gets 5 volts of power either from the USB or from an external power supply. So guys, in this video, I've explained you the basics of Arduino. And in the next video, we will install the Arduino IDE.